All right, example two, smack dab in the middle. We're gonna speed this up a little bit. Notice, what is our C value in this case? Remember we talked about this was just our C value. Our C value is in there, it's a zero. So I can tell you right now, my y-intercept is 0, 0, okay? Axis of symmetry, opposite of B, so my B value is -4. So opposite of that is +4, divided by 2 times A, so 2 times -2. And again, this is actually going to work out this time to -1. Remember, that number is so important. It has a second name. That was our H. And so to find the K, we take that number and we plug it back in. So be careful on this one. -2 parentheses squared minus 4 parentheses. You don't need to write the plus 0. And we're going to take that -1 and we're going to plug it in. Now, I need you to be careful. Some of us aren't the best at PEMDAS. You exponents first, exponents first. So -1 squared gives me +1. +1 times -2 gives me -2, okay? Then -4 times -1 gives me +4. So when I add those together, I get +2. That's my K value. So I've got my H, where are we at? I've got my H and I've got my K. So what's my vertex? -1, +2. -1, +2. So now that I've got my vertex, I can move on to plugging it right in the middle of my table. -1, +2, right? -1, +2. One step backwards would be -2. Remember on the number line, one step forwards would be 0. Zero rings the bell, doesn't it? I'm being a little bit too nice to you guys by double dipping here, but 0, 0, we already know. 0, 0 is one of my points. Buy one, get one free, so I don't have to do anything. I know that's going to be 0 as well. Remember, that's our BOGO. Don't forget, it's a buy one, get one free deal. So now that I've got my 3 points, let's graph. -1, 2 is right there. 0, 0 is right here. And -2, 0 is right there. So my parabola opens downward this time. I kind of missed. Opens downward this time. And there you are. You're opening downward. There, okay. Again, we're going to come back to the domain and range in just a second. Let's just knock this one out really quickly. This is my C value here. So my y-intercept is 0, -4. My axis of symmetry, don't get fooled by this. My axis of symmetry, a lot of people will start running. They go, okay, opposite of 4, okay, da-da-da. No, 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 no. What is our B value, right? What is our B value? Our B value isn't even there, right? This is actually 0x right here in the middle, plus 0x. So that means it's just 0 divided by 2 times 1, which is a waste of time because it's 0. So that's my H. And so if I plug 0 in, that's kind of a waste of time too. 0 squared minus 4, it's still just going to be -4. So there you go. In this case, our y-intercept and our vertex are the same thing. That's okay. That's allowed. 0, -4 is my vertex. And we'll go ahead and put that in the table. 0, -4. One step backward would be -1. One step forward would be +1. We don't have either of those points already. So all we do is we go back to the original equation, something squared minus 4, and we just plug in one of these numbers. It doesn't matter which one. I'm just going to plug in 1. So 1 squared minus 4 is 1 minus 4, which is -3. So I plug in that -3, buy one, get one free. So that's -3. Let's plot it. 0, -4 is down here. And then 1, -3 and -1, -3. There's my parabola, right? So hopefully these last two videos have given you the idea, given you the process on how we actually graph a parabola that's in standard form. The last video for today is coming up, and it's going to be all about domain and range.